welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Sarah Armstrong-Montoya. She is the CEO of Cordoba Minerals. And Sarah, it's good to see you. How are you?
Hi, Steve. Great. Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing very, very well. Thank you. And super excited. You had a really big news release out recently we'll talk about in just a second. But maybe you could just give us a bit of an overview of the company.
Sure. So Cordoba is a publicly listed company listed both on the tsx-v and OTC. We have two flagship projects. One is the San Matias Project in Colombia. And as you just mentioned, we recently, in the last 3 weeks, put out our pre-feasibility study. And the second project is in Arizona. We're copper bold. We are part of the Ivanhoe Group. So our motto is long and strong with copper there. We have two flagship shareholders. One is Ivanhoe Electric, which is led and founded by Robert Friedland. They hold 63% of the company. And we also have our Chinese partners, strategic partners, JCHX, which are an EPCM contracting company.
Okay. So you mentioned the pre-feasibility study. So let's talk about that because it was just released recently. Very positive numbers. Just give me an idea of the work that went into that and obviously some of the numbers that really pop out to everyone.
Sure. So actually, it's quite the feat that we got this pre-feasibility study done. We started it in January of 2020. And as you know, COVID was happening. So for the next 2 years, we had a lot of restrictions. We actually only had access to site for 9 months. And the reason that we did the pre-feasibility study was in Colombia, one of the permits required to build and construct the mine was due in November of last year. And their level of engineering studies for that permit is effectively the same as the pre-feasibility study. So great that we were able to get that done. It came out on the economics, we're $415 million after-tax NPV at a discount of 8%. It is a modest-sized project, but very economical and very buildable. And this thing looks like we're going ahead to build it. So it's around 100 million tons. It's predominantly copper, with 70% copper. We've got nearly 30% silver, and a little bit of silver in there, a little bit of a silver credit.
Okay. It mentioned that 13-year life of mine. Is that something you're looking at potentially increasing?
Yeah, so actually as part of this, given the restriction that we had on access that I just mentioned, basically we had to cull everything that was not mission critical. So in the PEA, we had included three other satellite pits within that study. We weren't able to include them in the pre-feasibility study, and we had to only focus on the Alacran deposit. So those three satellite pits will come back in at feasibility study, and that's pure upside. We were also restricted on doing the amount of drilling that one would normally do at a pre-feasibility study level. So we will need to do at least 30,000 meters of drilling, infill and resource drilling at the feasibility study level. So we would anticipate sort of improved grade. We'll be one of those very unique projects that actually increases its resource and grade between pre-feasibility study and feasibility study, which would then also have a positive impact on the life of mine. I guess just quickly there, one of the other big changes between the PEA and the PFS is when we did the PEA, we were very conscious of market conditions at the time, and there wasn't a lot of capital around for juniors and to build this type of project. So we very intentionally started off at a production of 8,000 tons per day, slowly increasing to 16,000 tons per day by year six. Economics have changed. The market conditions have changed in our favor, we think. And so this project is starting off at 22,000 tons per day, hence the shortened mine life. But as just mentioned, we do hope to extend that back out again with the feasibility study stage.
Is that something that's planned for 2022 then? Is there going to be a lot of work specifically on that?
Yes. So right now we've got a pretty busy 2022. We're full steam ahead here. We're really happy with the results from the pre-feasibility study. And right now we are defining all of the terms of reference, I guess, to go out to bid for all of our contractors. I expect in the next month we'll have locked down everyone that we're going to be working with. And in March sometime we should be kicking off the feasibility study. Importantly, we'll be simultaneously, the same as with the pre-feasibility study and that first Colombian permit required to build and construct the mine, we'll be simultaneously doing the feasibility study and the environmental impact assessment study in Colombia, which is the second permit to build and construct our mine. So 2022, we'll be doing both of those studies. We'll be advancing a lot with the communities. We have 12 communities within our area of interest. Three of them will need to be relocated. So we've got a dedicated team on the ground that we're reaching agreements with those communities And the relocation will be implemented once we get the project licensed and ready to construct.
Okay. So does that take most of your focus now? Are you looking at the US property at all?
We are. We're drilling at the US property. We're currently doing exploration drilling at both properties. So feasibility drilling aside separately, we started exploration drilling again or resumed again at Alacran in November of last year. And our Perseverance project in Arizona, we started in October. So we're still drilling at both of those. I haven't announced anything to the market yet. So sealed lips and for the next couple of months until I can release some results.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. And it's quite a staggering accomplishment to be able to do all of that, as you mentioned last year during COVID, because it really was a tough to work for everybody. So good on you guys. Congratulations on that. And congratulations on the numbers. Very good. Sarah, nice to meet you. Thank you very much. And give me an update. And it sounds like you're going to have a lot of news flow this year as well. Very busy.
I hope so. Thank you so much for your time, Stephen. We'll keep in touch and keep giving you updates.
All right. Sounds good. There is Sarah Armstrong-Montoya. She is the CEO of Cordoba Minerals. We'll be right back.